In this video, I am going to explain important core connection. I would like to focus on two muscles today. First one is this one. This is transverse abdominis. Transverse abdominis. This is the deepest layer among core muscle. Thus, this muscle cannot flex your abdomen a lot like rectus abdominis. This muscle is deep and thin. Thus, this muscle has important role for stability. Okay? Stability more than mobility. Okay? Stability more than mobility. Okay? The next one is this one. This is main breathing muscle. This is diaphragm. This is, of course, inside of thorax and abdomen, right? I would like to explain important anatomical connection between two guys. But first thing first, let's do a quick review for each muscle's attachment. Okay? So, transverse abdominis, that attaches to xiphoid process and costal cartilage, right here. And there is connective tissue on midline. This part is called linea alba. Linea means line, okay? And alba means white. So, white line. You see this kind of line in the six pack. This is a longitudinal line of six pack. You know that, right? Then let's go to a posterior view. Okay, this is posterior view. This is transverse abdominis. This muscle attaches to 12th rib. Okay, 12th rib. And let's go to inferior. This is iliac crest. Iliac crest is pelvis, right? Then you don't see the final part. There is fascia on backside of body. This is very broad and strong fascia. This is thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia. This muscle attaches to this fascia. Okay, this is very important for a lumbar connection. I'm coming back this later, okay? So basically, transverse abdominis attaches to everywhere in abdominal area, okay? Now, I'm going back to diaphragm. Okay, diaphragm basically attaches to costal cartilage, and it goes back. Then, part of attachment is not actually bone. It attaches to tendon, about here. This is called central tendon. Central tendon. And you see, diaphragm attaches to lumbar spines. There's kind of this place on left side as well. So there are two elongation place. Okay, this kind of elongation place is called crura. Crura means leg. This is like legs of diaphragm. Crura attaches to lumbar spines. I'm also coming back to this later. Now, costal cartilage is removed. This is transverse abdominis. Okay. Then, this is diaphragm. You don't see costal cartilage, but when you remove costal cartilage, oh my gosh, there's connection between transverse abdominis and diaphragm. So what can I say? So I can say there is connection between transverse abdominis and diaphragm. So if transverse abdominis gets tight, this tightness can affect diaphragm. Or if your diaphragm is not working properly, this dysfunction may affect transverse abdominis. Let's review each function. What is function of transverse abdominis? That is stability of core, right? What about diaphragm? That, of course, breathing, right? Breathing is important. So if core doesn't work properly, maybe your breathing can be affected. Vice versa. If your breathing is not working properly, core stability may be decreased, right? That is why this connection, let's say this part, is very important for both thorax and abdominal area. I'm gonna say it again. This is transverse abdominis. This is diaphragm. At this level, there is connection. By the way, costal cartilage is removed. There's connection between these two muscles. When either one place gets tight, that can affect the other one. Vice versa, if this part gets tight, that can affect the other one. Thus, this connection is very important. And do you remember, where is the posterior part of attachment of transverse abdominis? Let's go back. This part. Do you remember this part? This is fascia. This is thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia also attaches to lumbar spines. So if you can't use transverse abdominis, maybe your lumbar spine is not very stable, because stability is main function of transverse abdominis. No wonder your lumbar spine is not well stabilized, right? Then let's think about diaphragm transverse abdominis connection. If diaphragm doesn't work properly, transverse abdominis doesn't work properly. If this muscle doesn't work properly, maybe lumbar spine is not stabilized because of this myofascial connection. Let's look the other way. Do you remember? Diaphragm attaches to lumbar spines via crura, right? Crura is leg of diaphragm. So, if your lumbar spine doesn't work properly, maybe transverse abdominis doesn't work properly, then your diaphragm doesn't work properly, right? Then crura, if crura doesn't work properly, diaphragm doesn't work, lumbar spine doesn't work, then maybe your transverse abdominis doesn't work properly. Oh my gosh, this deep structure connection is very, very important for both abdominal area, core area, and thorax and breathing. This is very important for our daily activity and athletic movement. Very important place. So if you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.